Hello, hello! Welcome back to another Legacy video. Today we're going to be demonstrating how to produce a baseball bat on the Maverick CNC machine. But first we're going to be jumping to the software and showing just the flow process of how we created the tool passing our conversational cam turning software, and then we'll also go over to our Vectrex software to show how to do a wrapped engraving process. This is to show how to turn a normal baseball bat into a trophy bat. Then we'll jump over to the machine and we'll actually kick out some sawdust. So stick around to see the final results. To kick things off, let's show you the flow process of the tool pass used not only to turn the baseball bat with our conversational cam turning software, but also to do the wrapped engraving using our Vectrex software. So the top profile is what we used here to program in our turning software. The bottom here is what we imported into our Vectrex to do the wrapping. There were four cutters used in total for this project. You have the surfacing cutter that I used just to rough the material around. We have the 2-inch diameter core box, which actually turns the majority of the body of the baseball bat. You have a 1/2-inch core box that turns the handles and both ends of the baseball bat. And then our 60-degree V cutter, which does the custom engraving that wraps around the circumference of the baseball bat itself. So when we were actually programming this, I had all the parameters for our surfacing cutter, all the parameters for our 2-inch core box, and all the parameters for our 1/2-inch core box. Let's walk through the sequences of how this takes place. The first thing that we did is we took our blank and we're just going to rough out the material to get it to a general shape, and we're doing that with the surfacing cutter. And each surfacing process requires four parameters. It requires a starting position, an ending position, a starting diameter, and an ending diameter. And that is for one process. There are technically 7 shoulders here, or 7 turned round sequences that need to take place. And that's the first thing that happens in conversational cam. Second we have is our arcs for the turning of the baseball bat. And there's 5 arcs that need to be turned using our contour turning process with the 2-inch diameter core box cutter. And each arc will need very similar information. It needs a starting position, it needs an ending position, it needs a starting diameter, and an ending diameter. The last piece is it needs to know the radius of the arc itself, and we'll then program 5 arcs back to back to back. After that 2-inch diameter core box bit finishes turning the bat, then we switch over to our third cutter, and we're gonna have the 1/2-inch core box also perform the same contour techniques with these 3 arcs to turn the handle. So it will need the same pieces of information. Afterwards, that same cutter is then just going to perform a straight turning tool profile on the end for a cut mark. And then to finish, it will come over here and turn the contour of this arc on the other end of the bat to not only to give us the radius of the end of the bat, but also to give us a cut mark to trim both ends so that this bat is to the right length. So if we look at our conversational cam turning software, we have all of those processes already taken place. We have the 7 turning round processes to rough the machine round. We have 5 large contour processes for the 2-inch. We have 3 small contour processes for the handle. We have an end profile and the end contour. And then we have also the beginning contour for the cut marks. So we simply just click on G-code. It kicks out all the G-code for our legacy CNC machines. And we're able to then take this to the machine and we'd be able to turn our baseball bat. Let's finish off here with the software by showing you what happens in Vectrex. So in our Vectrex software, we have our baseball bat profile and we needed to create a 3D model so that we can engrave on that 3D surface. So that 3D model looks like this. All we did is we took the shape of the bat and it did a 2-rail sweep across the circumference of the diameter of the blank that we're using. So now that we have this 3D surface, we can now place engravings on here. And if we look at the engraving here, or the vectors, you can see that they're distorted. I want to show you real quick what happens if we place the engraving on those surfaces with it not being distorted. So here is if the baseball bat was already turned, but it's actually a carving process to show you what happens realistically in a simulation. And then here we have the world champs and the elliptical shape going around that. So that looks uniform right now, but if we wrap that up you're going to see very quickly that it's now distorted because the engraving is taking place on a surface that is constantly changing in diameter. So as the diameter gets smaller, so does technically the engraving vectors because of that distortion. So we need to fix that by going back to our vectors and reverse the distortion in the opposite direction. So that's what we've done here, is we've just found out what the diameter points are across the length, and we adjusted the distortion at those points by the same percentage difference of those different diameters across that vector. So now if we show you the toolpath with the distortion taking place, we'll reset, do a 3D simulation one more time, and we have the now distortion engraving with also the distortion border. So here it doesn't look correct, but if we now wrap this back up, it now looks perfect. We can see that the text is all uniform, the ellipse is all uniform, and this is ready to take to the machine. So let's jump over to the machine and let's create some sawdust and see how this produces the baseball bat. All four cutters will be touching off Legacy's Smart Tool Touchpad. This will eliminate all manual tool touch-off procedures and ensure that the cut depth tolerances are spot on. As stated previously, the surfacing cutter turns 7 turning round processes to rough the blank before the contour processes take place. Next, the 2-inch diameter core box cutter turns the shape of the baseball bat. The smooth finish is accomplished by only stepping over 2.5% of the diameter of the cutter. For this example, that's 50 thousandths of an inch per rotation. Next, the finer details of the baseball bat are turned using the 1/2-inch core box cutter. The step over for this tool is only 12 thousandths of an inch. At this point, the shape of the baseball bat is complete and you could use it for gameplay. But if you desire to make it into a trophy bat, we'll use the 4th and final cutter, the 60-degree V cutter, to perform our wrapped engraving. Once machined, all you have to do is trim the ends, do a little sanding, and apply a finish, and this project is ready to go. Well, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. If you did, press that like or thumbs up icon below the video. Now, if you're interested in the nitty-gritty details on how we designed and programmed projects like this baseball bat, I recommend you go over to our website at legacywoodworking.com. There you can find all of our training options and how to participate in those training options even if you're not a Legacy customer, including our live webinars that are held on Wednesday evenings. Also on the website, you can find an online store if you're just interested in purchasing pre-made projects similar to the baseball bat. I'll make it easy on you. Just click the link right over there to go to our website. Now, if you're interested in our CNC machines, also go to the website, but I recommend that you watch one of our favorite videos, The Best CNC Machine, by clicking the link below. Don't forget to press that subscribe button and check mark that little bell icon to receive notifications. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.